How can one live in the world amidst duality, conflict, confusion, and yet still be not involved into it? Very often I have said, be in the world, but do not let the world be within you. What does it mean? I'll have to take certain examples to explain this point. How one can be in the world, doing everything like anybody else, but in a totally different manner. Everyone has to be in the world, in the world of conflict and duality. But how do you interact with the people, circumstance and situation that depends on your consciousness? I will take a few examples. Each one of you must have seen horse riding, whether you have done it or not, but you know. In order to do the horse riding, you have a horse well prepared with saddle on it. You dress up and you put your one foot, the left foot, onto the left side of the saddle, and then you take the right leg across the horse to carry it on the other side. Suppose you are going to ride the horse. You are holding the reins of the horse and your one foot is on the left side of the saddle, and I suddenly call out to you, stay as you are, don't move, and I ask you a question, where are you? Can you answer that question? In a way you are on the ground, but you are not. In a way you are on the horse, but you are not on the horse. You are hanging in the air. Horse is on the ground. Where else the horse could be? But you are not on the ground. Yet still, if you are not on the ground, how can you be? And you are not on the horse because your one foot is on the saddle and the other foot is in the air. You have not completed the process of sitting on the horse. You have started it. You are not on the ground. Yet still you are on the ground. Then where are you? If you analyze and understand the situation, in a way you are on the ground, because horse has its 4 feet grounded to the earth. You are trying to climb up on ride the horse. You have put one foot onto this one side of the saddle. Then you have to take your right leg across the horse back to carry it on the other side. In a way you are on the ground, and in a way you are not. In a way you are on the horse, yet still you are not. This is the situation of the awakened one. He is in the world, but his consciousness is not of the world. His consciousness is not of the world. Normally, what happens when we are interacting in the world of objects and beings, circumstances and situations? You enter into the office. Your office colleague says to you, be careful with the boss, he is a hog. It is not easy to deal with him. You cannot please him. And that settles in your mind. You continue to interact in that way. But if there is an awakening in you, you will realize that we are part of one harmony. We are created by the same light that I was created. God did not create him differently than you. Your outer appearance is different. When electric stove is made, it is made for a particular purpose. Air conditioner is made for another purpose. And all these things you need for your house, for your comfort. You cannot say that I don't like the electric stove, but I like the air conditioner. No, for your comfort you need everything. Just as when you are having an equation, a chemical equation, two molecules of carbon dioxide and one molecule of oxygen in the presence of manganese dioxide give water. What is the role of manganese dioxide in that reaction? Nothing. It is a catalyst. It simply helps in the process of the chemical reaction, but it does nothing. The carbon and oxygen, two different elements, have to interact with one another. What is the common denominator is manganese dioxide that allows that reaction to complete. If there is an understanding and awareness in you that we are all made from the same light, two people are sitting in the same room breathing one another, where is the air, that atmosphere that is there? How that atmosphere, the air, is created? You are breathing, you are exhaling. The other is breathing, other is exhaling. So the air inside the room is a combination of the air exhaled by you and the other. So you are inhaling the same person and you, yet you are antagonistic. If you understand this, we have a different purpose, different frame of mind. There may be a difference of opinions, but we are working on a common goal. You are driving on the road, someone gives you a bad ride. You speak out of your mind. No. If someone says something, you will say that the person is hawk, doesn't know how to act. But I will say, a dog speaks in his own way, a cat speaks in his own way. Maybe that person did not get the opportunity that was given to you to have a deeper understanding of the circumstances and situation. I'll feel compassion on that. Give you an example that was narrated to me some time ago by a person. The person was working in an office. She had a 5-year-old daughter, and during the summer holidays, she has to go to work, the father has to go to work. The girl was staying with the maid at home. The whole day the girl is playing with her toys. Maybe she will watch her television shows, talk to the maid in between. But the love that she requires from her parents, she is being deprived for those 12 or 13 or 14 hours. One day the call bell rings. The girl realized that it is time for my mother to come. As the mother comes, the girl rushes to get a hug. The mother yells at her, "What kind of house condition you have put all the toys scattered all about. A five-year-old daughter. Mother yells at her. The girl says, "Mother, I'm sorry, I'll go and fix it up." A five-year-old child, she goes and fixes up and goes back. Then at the dinner time, she comes out. She said, "Mom, it looks like during the day you had a very hectic day. Let me make a cup of tea for you so you can relax." The mother immediately realized her mistake and she gave a hug to her child. Look at the understanding of the child. She told the mother, "It looks like you had a hectic day today and you seem to be tired. Let me make a cup of tea for you." What kind of awareness this child has exhibited and the mother has exhibited. Mother could not separate herself from the circumstances and situations. And the child has exhibited a kind of awareness that is rare for human beings. You are working in the office. You remember I used to, and that whenever my friends complain, I ask them, are the things ready? Because my friend has a garment factory. So whenever we get the orders, we place it on to him, he makes it and gives it to us. When we ask, "Are the things ready?" He said, "These workers, I don't know what to say about them. Today so many people are absent, tomorrow this is absent." I said, "You have to understand one thing. You are the boss in the business. You can come anytime and you can go anytime, but the workers have a schedule. They have to come at a particular time and leave. They do not have a transport facility like you have. They have to travel. They do not have the comfort like you have. You have to understand this. And they are also human beings like any one of us. Someone may get sick, or during the holidays, yes, someone may take disadvantage of that situation, but the reality is we have to treat human beings as human beings. You can do only when you have known your real face. You have grown into awareness, then you will realize that the other is also like you. First thing you ask, the person comes late, "Is everything okay? Are you okay? Just relax yourself, let me make a cup of tea for you, and then we will sit down and talk." Then you are keeping an avenue open, or the other way is you start yelling at the person, "Is this the time for you to come to the office? You did not ask what would have been the problem. Why did the person not come in time?" Yes, somebody may take advantage of your generosity, your compassion, but not always. Somewhere or the other person will realize your nature and will start acting accordingly. When you exhibit, you understand, try to understand from the animals. Dog never talks like a cat and cat never barks. They live in their own consciousness. It is only man who imitates a dog, who imitates a cat, imitates a monkey, imitates an owl in old age. Man gets old, he becomes a grandfather, he starts making monkey faces with the grandchildren. So it is the man who does all these things, but he never lives in his essential nature, the original face. It happened, King Janak, who is the father of the character in Hindu scripture Ramayana. A sannyasi came to him and he wanted to know how one can be in the world and be not of the world. How can he live a life of a renunciate? When Buddha becomes enlightened, where would he go and live? He has to live among the people. He has to face all the circumstances and situations like you and I face on a day-to-day basis. There is nowhere a world where Buddhas live or where the others live. The place is same. The same marketplace you go, the same street awakened one goes, the same flight you travel, the same flight your sheikh or the awakened one travels, but the upbringing is different, the understanding is different, your reaction to a particular circumstance and situation is different. If we begin to understand that, and if you have learned anything in the company of a sheikh or a master, then you start exhibiting it in your day-to-day life bit by bit. So this person comes to Janak and he says, how can one be in the world be not and not allow the world be within him? You are a king and yet still you are considered to be renunciate. How that is possible? So Janak said, at the moment I am very busy and by evening I will be finished and I will not like to let you go without my answering your question. But in the meantime, you go and visit my palace. It is a beautiful palace under construction. The window panels are not in place. The doors are not there. So the breeze blows from either side. The electricity is not fixed as yet, but the buildings are very beautiful. By the time you reach the other end, darkness would have come, so you have to carry a lamp with you. And the lamp during that time does not have the shade over it. So you have to make sure that the lamp does not, the flame does not put off. So you have to be mindful that the flame remains on, and it is only in the light of that flame that you can see the buildings and monuments. But you remember, when you are going with a flame in your hand, a lamp in your hand, without the shade, the breeze is blowing from the two sides, it can put off any time. So he goes and he visits the place. In the evening, the two met one another. Janak asked, Did you visit the place? The person replied, yes, I did. How did you find the place? It was beautiful. Were you able to see it? Yes, I saw it. But the king asked, where was your attention? He said, my attention was on the flame that it does not put off. Oh, really? Your attention was on the flame? Then how did you watch the buildings, the architect and so? When your attention was constantly, you were trying to keep your two hands around the flame that it does not put off, how could you see that? When your attention moves from the bodily consciousness, bodily consciousness is separate. Your body is separate from my body. But your mind is also separate from my mind. But your mind can think like my mind. But there is a soul beyond that, that is one. That light of which we are made is one. At that level there is oneness. At the level of the mind we may have different opinions, different level of understandings. We can look at the same situation in a different way. This diversity is very important. We can see many diverse opinions about a particular circumstance and situation, but at the top if we understand that we are made out of the same stuff, light. We are working on a common goal. The common goal is to develop something for the betterment of the humanity. Then all the other things become subservient. But if you are in the body consciousness, my body is black, your body is white, you are tall, I am short. You are in the body consciousness, then there is conflict, there is ego, there is this and that and so. You cannot reconcile. The conflict will come. The I am separate from her. She is a hog, I was told in the beginning, and yes, she is a hog. Look at how she is talking to me. I am a grown-up person. I am well qualified. But she does not know how to treat the human being. So the two are in the same position. She does not know how to treat the other, and you do not know how to treat a hog or a dog. When people come to my place in the showroom where we have the merchandise for display, and right on the other side there is a dog, my landlord has it, the dog remains tied. Whenever somebody comes, the dog barks. They are afraid to come in. I said, you just continue walking your way. The dog will not do anything to you. It is the dog's nature to bark. And this is a dog diplomacy. Dog barks at you, at the same time wags the tail. One place we go and they do not have a call bell whenever we have to deliver the rice. We blow the horn, the dog comes out. He is looking at the car and barking, wagging the tail and keep on turning back to look if the owner is coming out or not. We know, we observe, and I enjoy observing the behavior. Dog looks at the car, barks, turns back and to look at if the owner is coming or not, and barking the tail. He know that someone has come. Just now the owner will come and he will be tight and the gate will be opened. Maybe if I could read the dog's mind. Now for a little while, until these people are there, I will be tied. So barking at you, but turning the face and looking at the owner if it is coming out of the house. But you understand and you enjoy the season. This is why it is said that constant remembrance. But if you have blackened your heart, paper by writing, people write different, sometimes your priests ask you to write 100 times kalma or any particular mantra. So one day a person came and he brought at least 25 books that he wrote the name of God, whatever was told to him. So it came to my mind, what is the purpose of writing all this? You have blackened the white paper with black ink. The rivers should be your heart that is blackened of soot of ignorance. That needs to be whitened. And the moment that happens, your circumstance, your approach in dealing with the people will be different. So when that sannyasi, the renunciate, told that I was trying to make sure that the flame does not put out, the king said, that is my situation. I am in the world because to be in the world, I have to live like anybody else. I have been given an opportunity to work as a king. I have to take care of the kingdom, take care of every single aspect of it. And yet still I have to remember that I am the made out of the stuff of which the other is also made. So with that understanding, I deal with the people, circumstance and situations. There are so many examples of explaining things like these. A Sufi was living in a, was a rich person, kind of a small king. A person comes to visit him. Again, the same question he had, how to be in the world and not be of this world. He welcomed him, take care of him, offered him the best of the food, comfort, entertainment, whatever was possible. Then in the night, asked him to retire. He still wanted to know, what? I have come with a question and he has not answered my question yet. So when he went to sleep, the bed was very comfortable, but on top of the bed where he was sleeping, from the ceiling with a thin thread, a sword was tied and was hanging. Imagine a sword is tied from the ceiling with a thin thread hanging over you. Would you be able to sleep? You are tossing and turning. So in the morning, the Sufi asked, did you have a good night's sleep? He said, sleep? What kind of joke was this, that a sword was hanging from the ceiling, tied with a thin string, thread? How can I sleep and be comfortable? All the time I was wondering, thinking that any moment this thin thread may break and the sword may fall on me. He said, this is my situation. I am connected by an invisible thread to that which is, to the absolute consciousness. Any moment that thread can break and I will be no more. I am gone. So every moment I have to remember this. When we say Kalma La Ilaha Illallah Muhammadur Rasulallah, is it to be remembered? And when a situation comes, you act differently. I understand, I heard in India during the time of October month before Diwali, there is a play of Ram Leela, the portrayal of Ram is played all around. It is now the 10 days of the period beginning from this week is known as the period when Ram Leela is being played, the entire act of Ram Leela is being played. So in that, The people from the village, the ordinary actors, they are to play different role of Hanuman, Ram, Sita, and all these things. So it happened that the person who was playing the role of Ravan, he has to come, he was, that character has to be a little bigger character. So he comes in his usual gait and he looks at the bow, walks around and goes back as if he cannot break it. So the person who was playing the role of Ram, he looked at him and he laughed. He come back and he held the bow and break it. But he was not supposed to do. But the two people, one who was playing the character of Ram, the other was playing the character of Ravan, they were enemies in the village, always as competition. Both of them liked the same girl. He breaks the bow. So then the scene has to be changed. He said, did you bring the right kind of bow? Then he inquires and asks to go and get a new, just to change scene. In another situation, now he forgets that he is playing an act. The act involves that he is not supposed to break the bow. Instead, he moves around, shows the effort that he is trying to lift it, but he cannot, and he goes, has to go back. But he forgot his bodily consciousness. His bodily consciousness comes onto the surface. This is how it happens always.